Hey everyone, my name is Mr. Beckstrom, and I will be your Calculus 1 teacher this semester. And I just wanted to do a short welcome video, kind of showing you how to get started and what programs we're going to be using. You can ignore some of the specifics on the main page right now, as I am working on those as we speak. But let's first talk a little bit about how this class works. So this is a 16-week asynchronous class, and asynchronous means that there's going to be no live sessions. So you're going to be doing all of the work on your own pace, your own time. There'll be videos, which I'm going to go through for you to watch. There'll be forums for you to ask questions. You can always contact me directly. I prefer by email, but sometimes you can actually get me on the phone as well. I also am the department chair for mathematics at Durham Tech, so I can help you in other ways too if you have any kind of scheduling conflicts. But for now, let's concentrate on this class here. So when you first log in to your Sakai site here, you're going to see an overview page, and on that overview page, I'm going to have a lot of very useful information, such as my contact information, my office hours, the Google Sheets calendar. Please save this Google Sheets calendar to your favorite, not website, but browser. And it will list the due dates and the test dates and all that good stuff for you. And if there's anything that needs to be updated, it will update automatically there. So let's take a look at that. It's going to look just like this when the quiz is open, holidays, all that good stuff. So I don't know which browser you're using, but whatever it is, just click on the favorites and add it to your tab or your favorites. And that way you can always know when things are assigned, when things are due, and all that good stuff. All right, we're also going to be using My Math Lab, which is, let me go over here. All right, My Math Lab here. So once you get here, if you've never used it before, you're going to register as a student. You'll need an access code that's either gotten from the bookstore or it is gotten directly on the website. You can pay for it there as well. But once you create your account, please use your Durham Tech email in order to do that, to prevent some issues, known issues that we've been having. Once you get in here, you're going to see Math MAT 271002. You're going to click on that, and your tabs are going to look different from mine, but you'll see your assignments that are open and that are and when they're due. You can click directly on those. You can go to your grade book, and that is going to allow you to review old quizzes and homework that you've done. It also has a static ebook, which is an electronic copy of the textbook, and you can also go to that ebook directly from chapters and sections. So you just pull up. You can either do an interactive ebook, which is going to have you download the free version of Wolfram CDF Player, or if you click on the static ebook and just click on that, it'll give you an entire copy of the book, which is currently opening here. And it'll look something like this. You can go directly to the page number if you know it. Oh, optimization problems. Yes, this is probably the hardest section in the class, so just keep that in mind. And then you can switch around between different sections and different chapters. You can do searches. You can also put the page number in there. So let's say we want to go to page 235. It'll pop right up there. And you can also switch pages down here. So you can, if you're starting with the beginning of the chapter and you're just reading through it, you can just use these page changers here on the bottom. All right, so that's pretty much going to be what my math lab is used for and looks like. Again, it's going to house both your homeworks and your quizzes for the weeks. All right, let's go back over to Sakai. I put the bookstore link here. Just copy and paste that in your browser in order to find out what you need for the course. And let's go through that just a little bit here. So what you're going to need for the course is two options. The more expensive option comes with a physical copy of the textbook along with the code and the ebook. The less expensive of the two options just comes with the code and the ebook. There's no physical copy. So both options are going to get you an electronic copy of the book, but the more expensive option will get you a physical hard copy of the book as well. So that's just totally up to you. You'll see my math lab code down here, and here's the required materials, including the text and the graphing calculator, TI-83 or TI-84. All right, so once you kind of get an overview of this, you can go down to the syllabus here and click on this, and you'll see a whole, how many pages is that? It's a lot of pages. 11-page syllabus, including, again, a lot of the stuff that's on the overview screen, including office hours. By the way, my Friday office hours from 9:30 to 11:30 will be virtual, and all of the rest will be in person. It goes through the policies, 10-point grading scale, the drop date, the student-initiated withdrawal date, how absences work. Let me kind of scroll down here. We're using a grading scheme, and how this works is you can either use one of these two columns in order to calculate your grade. So, for example, if you use this first column, remote tests are worth 20% and homework is worth 5%. Now, if you're using the second column, remote tests is worth 10%. And homework is worth 15%. And what happens is your totals are put into this grading calculator at the end of the semester, and it's going to find out which one gives you the higher grade, and that's the one that we're going to use. Now you might ask, why would we do that? And that's so you have more control over your own grade. Some students feel more comfortable on tests, and sometimes they'll miss a few homeworks, and some students, vice versa. They'll make sure they get all the homeworks done, but they sometimes have test anxiety and don't do as well. So this kind of this is I'm trying to say it here. This will be tailored towards whatever style works best for you. All right, so we're gonna have three tests and a final exam. One of the tests and one of the final exams will be on campus, and we'll talk a little bit more about that. The other two will be online. We are just getting a software called CrowdMark, and I will send information out on that as soon as it's ready. It goes through a lot of different college resources as far as tutoring services and computer labs, counseling services, all kinds of good stuff here. Breeze through that, see what can be used for you there. Here's going to be the test dates, final exam dates. There will be one project, that's the due date. And then here is the tentative fall schedule. And this includes when things are assigned, what week, when they're due, all that good stuff. All right. So go through here and let me know if you have any questions. Now, going back to Sakai, you can click your grade book in order to pull up your current grades. The tests and quizzes here, that's just going to be an entrance quiz. It's called the Getting Started quiz. You will need to complete that by August 24th in order to be officially enrolled in the class. So make sure you do that. It's just a 10-question, pretty easy quiz. based mostly off of information that's on the website and in the syllabus. Okay, so if I send you any email, it'll go out through here, but I usually send everything through announcements. Announcements goes out to all students, and then the email I can pick specific students to send to or to not send to, and that'll usually be if I'm only trying to send an email to a few of you. If some of you are late on something, I might send one out there. You can pretty much ignore this calendar because we are using the Google Sheets calendar. Meetings, I'm going to have an orientation. That orientation is going to be Tuesday, the 16th, August 16th at 4 o'clock, from 4 o'clock to 5 o'clock. And I will record that as well. So I hope some of you come there and ask some questions and do a little meet and greet as well. And that's pretty much everything on here. Again, the best way to reach me at is through email here at bextromz@durhamtech.edu. You can also get me on phone occasionally, and everything else should be here. So I welcome you to the class, and if you have any questions at all, please let me know. Thank you.